Okay, are you able to see the slide? Slide is visible. Anyone respond by voice?
Yes, sir.
Then today I will talk about various kind of linear transformation that we are calling it reflection. In last class, we had already discussed about projection and rotation. So today I will give a recap of rotation, then I will go to discuss about okay, fine. It is very sensitive. Fine, rotation. I will give a recap of rotation. So if you are talking rotation in 2D, so what will happen that in 2D it is taking this form. It is very sensitive. I don't know what it's called. So here I have taken one example of rotation. Usually you can see that this one is defined as a rotation from R2 to R2. Under the matrix, it is already given. It is a rotation transformation. And here, if you observe closely, then you will see that it is talking about rotation by an angle 90 degrees. If you take in the rotation matrix, so was like a 2D rotation matrix was like this way. First row was cos theta. Minus sin theta. Whenever I'm talking about rotation, talk about rotation in counterclockwise or anticlockwise. That sign we are always taking as a positive. And if you want to take clockwise, then you have to take minus theta. Then the matrix, rotation matrix will change. So here I'm taking counterwise rotation. So sin theta, cos theta. This is the rotation matrix. It is a very famous rotation matrix, and if you want to find a further property of this one, there are many properties that here you can observe that column are orthogonal to each other, that is perpendicular to each other. If you multiply, and also if you find the determinant of this matrix, it would be plus minus one, something like that. So the many properties are hidden here for this kind of matrix. So this matrix, we are calling it rotation matrix. So for this particular case, if you take theta equal to 90 degree, take theta equal to 90 degree, then what is the value of cos theta? Cos theta is cos 90 degree is zero. And sine 90 degree is one. So the minus sine 90 degree is minus one, and sine 90 degree 1, and again cos 90 degree 0. So you will get this kind of a rotation matrix. This is the rotation matrix of this transformation. So what under this transformation, what is happening? We observe rotation. So if you take any element in the, along x1 axis 1 0, and if you want to find the image under this rotation transformation, where it will go, it will be rotated by 90 degree. So from 1 0 to rotated to 0, 1. But while doing this rotation, you will observe that there will be no change in the magnitude. Only change in the direction is happening here. So same output, you can see it under the matrix operation. That it means that what is the resultant if you multiply rotation matrix 0, minus 1, 1, 0 with the given vector 1, 0. Then resultant definitely will be, there would be a 90 degree change. So you are multiplying with 1, 0. So under this multiplication, what would be your outcome? Always try to do practice like that. If you are having a linear transformation, always try to find out the associate matrix. What is the matrix of that transformation? Then do calculation. It would look very simple. So 0 times 1, 0. And 0 minus 1 times 0, 0. So first coordinate of resultant would be 0. And here, if you multiply second row with vector 1 0, then 1 time 1 is 1 plus 0 time 0 0. So you are getting resultant as 0 1. It simply says that your vector 1 0 has been transformed to 0 1 under this rotation matrix. Similarly, if you take element 0 2, so 0 2 it would be here, and if you multiply 0 2 with the rotation matrix, that means you are allowing a rotation by 90 degree. When you are multiplying with matrix, you are doing a algebraic calculation of the image. But when you see in geometry, that one is geometrical interpretation of linear corresponding linear transformation. So this here I am talking both geometry as well as algebraic approach both. So if you multiply here this is rotation matrix with 0 2, then easily you can look into one thing, that if you get maximum benefit of linear algebra, always apply both the practice, geometry and as well as matrix multiplication approach. So if you multiply this first row with this vector 0 2, what would be resultant? It would be just 0 times 0 0 plus minus 1 times 2. That means resultant would be minus 2. That means you are coming in negative side of x axis, and 1 times 0 is 0, 0 times 0 2 is 0. So this one minus 2 0. So this vector you are getting. That means you want to say that under the rotation matrix, given rotation matrix, 0 2 has been transformed to minus 2 0. This is the concept. If you take apart from if you take 1 1, where it will go? If you're taking element 1 1, then find the image of 1 1 under this rotation transformation. So definitely you do rotation here by 90 degree. If you want to get answer from the geometry itself, so this vector, it will be transformed where we do rotation. It was here, so it do rotation by 90 degree. So if you do rotation by 90 degree, then 1 1 becomes what? Minus 1 1. Why I am taking two plot? You can ask that question. So here I have taken two plot, that I told that linear transformation, it is a function. So I am giving a function approach. So that's why this plane is a domain plane of the transformation, domain plane. And this one is codomain, and range of a function happens to be a subset of a codomain. So range we will try to see in codomain. So that's why always I take two plot. That means this has been plotted here, and this has been, and this has been plotted here. This is the plane. Okay. So now, if you generalize the same transformation, if you want to write in the form of image, so this one is the given vector x, any general vector in R2, it will have a coordinate x1 and x2. And if you want to rotate it by 90 degree, what would be output of this one? Output would be this one. You can see that there is a interchanging of coordinate, and here this coordinate x2 becomes minus 2. So interchanging is happening and due to rotation. So you can observe that angle between image and the pre-image, that means angle between x and t of x, both are angle between, this is 90, always you observe a 90 degree. So this one is the general formula of transformation of a vector by 90 degree. If you take transformation or rotation by 45 degree, formula will be different. So it is a homework. You can try to find transformation of the rotation by rotation with angle 45 degree. So your approach or algorithm to solve a rotation rotational problem, it would be like this. Your rotational transformation, it would be like this. First, you need to know what through what angle you want to rotate, and next, once you are having angle, then find what is the matrix, rotational matrix. That I would like to give general rotation r theta. So what is the rotational matrix? So put here. This is your r theta. This matrix is your r theta. You can call it the general notation r theta rotational matrix in 2D. In 3D, things would be different. Right now, I don't want to discuss about 3D. So you will get rotation matrix. Once you are having rotation matrix, then define your transformation. Rotational transformation. T of x equal to r theta, what rotational matrix you got in the step 2, multiply with theta, sorry, x vector. This is the approach to find rotational transformation of any point by any plane, any r2 plane by angle theta. So here again, I am one more example I have taken. So here you can see, so this rotation, it is actually clockwise rotation. You can observe that this point has been transformed to, I am writing it rotation clock. Here I have already mentioned it is a clockwise rotation by 90 degree. You are rotating like this way. Direction of rotation is like this way, clockwise. And this point, it will come to image of this one. Several rotation you can find it like that. Similarly, if you want to rotate by 45 degree angle, then rotation matrix it would be something like this. And here 1 by root 2 was common, so it has taken out. So rotation, you can observe that every point will be rotated by 45 degree. If you are taking 1 0, and if you want to rotate where it will go, so 1 0, it will go under this rotation matrix, under with 45 degree angle, it will go to 1 1. And 0, 2, it becomes minus 2, 2. So this point, it becomes minus 2, 2. So you can do all the practice for this one, this kind of transformation. My intention is today, I would like to discuss a lot about reflection. So reflection is very, yes?
Sir, yes? Is there any general formula of, means like how many degrees you want the rotation, so you will get this matrix? या फिर याद ही रखना, अरे याद ही करना पड़ेगा सब.
जनरल फॉर्मूला आई टोल्ड दैट, नो यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर, योर मैथमेटिक्स डोंट नीड टू. दिस इज द जनरल फॉर्मूला ऑफ रोटेशन मैट्रिक्स, cos थीटा माइनस sin थीटा sin थीटा cos थीटा. सो हियर व्हाटएवर थ्रू व्हाटएवर एंगल यू वांट टू रोटेट वेक्टर, पुट दैट एंगल हियर. इफ यू वांट टू टेक 0 डिग्री, देन टेक 0 हियर. इफ यू वांट टू टेक 90 डिग्री, देन टेक 90. इफ यू वांट टू टेक 45, टेक 45. सो दिस इज द जनरल रोटेशन मैट्रिक्स.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Did you? Okay. So this is so always start with this way. That's why I have written this. No, this algorithm I have written. Whatever angle you want to proceed with, take that angle first. Then put that angle there in the rotation matrix. This rotation matrix, and then you will get your desired rotation matrix. And after that, define your rotation transformation by R matrix R theta times X. So this is a general approach. So rotation is very simple kind of operation, linear transformation. More generally, that we should focus much on reflection. So we had already seen projection along a line. Projection we had already seen in 2D. So today I will talk about reflection. So reflection is very interesting property of light. You might have already observe that a light is, it can be reflected from any dark or side or of a cube. Any reflection happens anywhere, depends upon that coefficient of that media, how much. So what is the coefficient, Young coefficient or something like that, Snell coefficient is there. So those kind of things, it is a property of light. In physics, you might have already gone through. Today I will talk about reflection as a geometric transformation. So suppose someone willing to reflect reflect in 2D, so definitely question would be, you are willing to reflect with respect to what line or with respect to what direction. So one question would come. So always you want to reflect a point with respect to certain line. So suppose this line we have taken L. L is the line, and for every line I had already mentioned that find a direction. So L is the line. You can talk it. This line is what is a very simple line I have taken. The equation of this line is minus x plus y equal to zero, or simply you can write it. This is the approach. Simply you can write it x2 equal to. I don't like x or y notation better because we have to look for n dimensional space as well. So x2 equal to x1. Better notation is like this. X2 equal to x1, or you can write it minus x1 equal to plus minus x1 plus x2 equal to zero. So now what is our intention is that, so we are having a line. So with respect to that line, define a direction. So line, definitely every line having a direction. So don't take generally direction vector. I had already told that every vector in that line represent a direction. So take a simplest one so that your calculation would be very simple. Unit vector would be 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. That looks complicated, but I would like to take direction of this line as 1, 1. 1, 1 looks very simple in calculation. Now, we try to find a reflection of a point. Take any general point. Suppose this is general point X. So it is a 2D point. So it will have two coordinates. X1 and X2. Now, you want to find reflection of this X vector with respect to this line. So what is the reflection of this one? If I simply ask reflection of this point with respect to this, it would be what? This would be this vector. This is the reflection of X with respect to line. So I would like to give notation of this one like this way. R E F, reflection of point, general point X with respect to line. So line is having a direction, so I will write with respect to V. Simply I will call it with respect to V. So our intention is how to find this. So this we have to find. We have to find a general formula of reflection. So it is very simple. You can look into here. So with the help of projection, you can find. Here you can project it only like this way. So this is your projection vector along the line. The projection of X along the line. This we are calling it orthogonal vector. So this line along this part of X along the line, we are calling it projection of proj of X along V. This we are calling vertical part or orthogonal part. We are calling X minus projection of X in the direction of V. Now, if you try to look closely, what would be this vector? This would be of the same length of X minus projection of X. So if you take total length of this one, what it would be? It would be total. If I am talking about total, it would be twice of this vector, this orthogonal component. Twice of this. Now, you are interested to find this reflection part. So give direction. I am very much again giving direction for every. So this vector is already given. This one was the x vector. So just apply a summation of vector concept. So what would be your reflection? Reflection is nothing, just how can you get reflection? Reflection subtract this twice of this orthogonal part from x, then you will get reflection. So your reflection, you can define it. I am writing separately. So reflection of a vector, it is a very very general definition. It is a true anywhere in any dimensional space with respect to reflection with respect to a line. It is true in 2D, it is true in 3D. So you are finding reflection with respect to a line, that is the line is having a direction. So reflection of with respect to this direction vector, we can write it, what would be this one? This one would be x minus, from the geometry you can see it here, x minus twice of x minus projection of x. So x minus 2 times of x minus projection of x along b. If you simplify it, then what would be the answer? If you simplify minus minus, it becomes plus. So it would be 2 times projection of x in along v, or in the direction of v. Both are same kind of similar kind of meaning, having similar kind of meaning. So projection of x in the direction of v minus, so x minus twice of x. So x minus, it is a multiplication, it is not x. X minus twice of x, so it would be just minus x. So this is your reflection of x with respect to a line. It is a formula of reflection. Suppose I have I'm asking to find what is the reflection of 1 1. Your question is find the reflection of 1 1 with respect to line, this given line, right? Now I'm not saying that 1 1 is, it is you might have already remembered that 1 1 is, it is a point in the same line. So reflection of that point with respect to a line, it would be the same. Answer would be same. You can check it by calculation. There is no issue. You can check it. Reflection would be same because 1 1 is along the line. If you take another point, reflection of 2 1. Reflection of 2 1 with respect to this line. So where it will go? Where would be 2 1? 2 1, 2 unit along x-axis and 1 unit along y-axis. So this is your 2 1. So if you want to find reflection of this point 2 1. Two one, then it will, where it will come? Reflection of 2 1, it would be 1 2. It will come something like here 1 2. You can calculate it through like this way formula. So projection, what was the formula of projection? You can write it like this way. So twice of, okay, times projection of x, we writing it like this way, dot product of x with v divided by dot product of v into v minus x, that is minus same vector. So this is the definition of reflection. So apply the same formula. So if you want to apply the same formula, before that what you do, get a general formula of this one. So if you have, if you further simplify this, so it will take this kind of form. Yes,
sir, will you please explain how did you derive that formula,
reflection formula? Okay, I had already explained. Okay, one more time I would like to explain here. Here I am taking a bigger picture. So this one is your R2 plane. Okay, you are you try to find reflection of points, 2D point, with respect to your line. So this is the given line. So I'm talking about a line. Equation of line is same this one. So once you are having line, I will ask that find the simplest direction. That means take any simple point on along that line. So this one I have taken. This is the direction of that. So now we want to project reflect a point x, any arbitrary point x. So this is any arbitrary point x. So always you draw position vector. This is the position vector of x. So position vector is having this kind of representation arrow. Okay, so we want to find reflection of x with respect to this line. So where would be reflection? Reflection, it would be like this way. This would be reflection. It looks like it would be reflection, but we have to calculate this. How can we calculate this? So our output would be this. So you can call this point reflection, rep, REF of x with respect to v, with respect to light or v. So what we will do in order to find reflection, first we project this one on the line. When we project on the line, then x will have two component. X has been decomposed into two component. One component is along the line. This component is along the line. This component we are calling it projection of x in the direction of v. So you can give name of this one. So this is what proj. The short name is proj. Projection of x in the direction of v. So v. And what is name of this vertical line? It is x minus vertical component of x. So it is x minus projection of, from the summation of vector you can easily get it. So x minus projection of x in the direction of v. So you got the orthogonal component of x and projected component of x. Projected component of x in the direction of line. You got both things. So now your next question is that you find the reflection. So what would be reflection? This graph is not looking symmetric. So reflection would be this little bit. So this is the reflection, not this point. Don't include this. So this is the reflection. So how can you get? So you have already come across that this line is this vector is x minus project of x, and this one is also of the same length and also in the same direction. If you take in this direction, this one is also same direction. From geometry easily you can see that this one and this one both are the same vector. If you consider this complete vector between reflection and projection, then what it would be? It would be twice of this. It would be twice of this. Twice of this. Okay. So you are interested to find this vector. So take a position vector notation. Now apply sum of vectors. So what it say? This vector plus this vector equal to this x. So from there you can derive that what is x is already given. You know about x. X is your arbitrary point. For that we want to find reflection. So you know about that. And with once you know about x, you know about this portion as well. So both are known to you. What is unknown to you? This reflection vector is unknown to you. So you have to find reflection vector. So what would reflection vector? It would be x minus, that is this vector minus this bigger vector, this vector. So what is this vector? This vector, I told that it is twice of x minus projection of x. So twice of x minus projection of x. X minus this orthogonal x minus projection of x. This is it talking about in the direction of v. So this I think derivation might be clear to you. This is the way out to derive. So I was here. I think your question might have already resolved. And if you further have a doubt, just do 1-2 time practice, then you will come across. You will know that. And further, if you have problem, then let me know. I will explain it again. Okay. So I am coming to this general formula of this one. So I need to write this one in term of general formula. So it is already in general formula. So I have to obtain it in inner product. So what would be? It would be twice of direction is 1-1. So x is having coordinate x1 and x2. So if you do a scalar multiple of x with direction 1-1, then what would be the? It would be twice of x1 plus x2 times. Now, what is the inner product of v with itself? That means inner product of 1 with itself. If you simplify, you will get 2 times v. What is v? It is again vector 1-1 minus x. X is having 2 coordinate, so you can call it minus x1 x2. It is like that. Now here we are going to find reflection of vector 2-1 with respect to this line or with respect to the direction. So what would be? So apply this formula directly and get this solution. So I will talk about another way to calculate reflection as well. So here just go with respect to formula. So twice of we are going to find reflection of 2-1 with respect to direction 1-1. So it would be twice of x1 plus x2. X1 plus x2 is what? 2 plus 1, that means 3 divided by 2 in the direction of 1-1. So 1-1 is coming minus x. X is what? It is itself 2-1. So here 2-1 we have to put it. 2-1. Now simplify this. 2-2, it will cancel out. Then the remaining thing would be 3 times 1-1. And that means 3-1-3-3 minus 2-1. So directly I am doing calculation. So it would be 3 minus 2 is 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. Easily you can see that what I had already discussed. So reflection of 2-1 with respect to line x2 equal to x1 or with respect to direction 1-1 is what? 1-2. Easily you can see that. If suppose someone is asking, what is the reflection of a point? If you are taking a point here in the along x2 axis, then what is the reflection of this point with respect to this line? So reflection definitely it will come in x1 axis. You can check that as well. So reflection of this one is example one. Example one. Say we are finding reflection of second point. Then third example, I'm taking it. We try to find the reflection of any point on x y axis or x2 axis. So any point on x2 axis, first coordinate would be 0 and second coordinate it would be non-zero. So suppose we are taking 0-2. What is the reflection of this one with respect to line? From the geometry, you can say that reflection would be 0, but algebraically you have to calculate that. So if you want to calculate from algebra, so again you have to apply same technique. So it would be 2 times 3 plus, 0 plus 2. 0 plus 2 is what? 2. So 2 times 2 divided by 2 in the direction of 1 1 minus x. X is here 0 2. So we are finding the reflection of 0 2. So this one is the calculation approach. So 2 2 will cancel out and simplify your further. So it becomes what it becomes, this part part becomes, first part becomes 2 2. So 2 minus 0 is 2 and 2 minus 2 is 0. So you are getting a vector 2 0. So reflection of 0 2 with respect to this line is what? 2 0. Easily you got this. So you will get every solution. So what you do just for homework perspective, you take another line. If you change the line, your reflection would be different. Yeah, definitely your problem will be different. So take a line, this line. So what is the equation of this line? First, your first again recall algorithm. So if you are writing equation of a line, you want to project with respect to certain line. So first write down the equation of line, draw this, then find the direction, a simple direction vector, simple direction vector v, then find the projection of a general point with respect to v. You have to find the first projection, you have to find in the direction of v, then finally find reflection. Then find reflection. So anyhow, in order to find reflection, you have to find projection first. Then you will be able to find reflection of a point with respect to a line. So these are the step for finding reflection of a point with respect to a given line. Remember that right now I'm not talking about reflection with respect to a plane or projection with respect to a plane. I'm not talking about right now. I'm talking about very simple question. So here, this is the line. So if you want to write equation of this line, so that means first step is write the equation of this line. What is the equation of this line? It is x1 equal to minus x1, x2 equal to minus x1. So from here, easily you can see that what is the direction of this one, this line? It would be simple direction, take minus 1, 1. So you got both things. And also you are having the formula of reflection. Using this formula, you can calculate any reflection of any point. So it is your homework. Try yourself and get the reflection of several points. Like take 2, 1, 1, 2. This one would be 1, 2, 2, 1, and different variety of points. Take this point, take all these points. So take different kind of point and find the reflection of all those points just for practice purpose. It is a homework. You do it by practice. And if you further face any problem, you can put your doubt there in Google Classroom. I will solve it. There would be no issue. So keep on doing practice. It is not like that once I'm asking to solve some problem, don't leave it. You need to do practice in order to understand things. So it is here a reflection with respect to vertical axis. What is the vertical axis? This is the vertical axis. So here we are talking about reflection with respect to so this line, vertical line. So what is the direction of vertical line? Direction of vertical line is 0, 1. Simple direction always take. So direction of a vertical line is 0, 1. So this is the vector, direction vector. And then apply the same formula, previous formula, and find the reflection of. First, you need to find the, you got the direction, then find the projection with respect to this line of any general point. Always write down projection formula, then go for reflection formula. Projection with respect to this direction. So what would be that projection, so it would be inner product of x with v divided by inner product of v with itself in the direction of v. So if you simplify this, always simplify in simple. So if you simplify, you are taking dot product of x with 0 over x is having to coordinate x1 and x2. If you are taking dot product, then x1 times 0 is 0 and x2 times 1 is x2. Divide by what is the dot product of inner product of 0, 1 with itself? It would be 1. 0 times 0 plus 1 times 1 in the direction of 0, 1. So this one is your formula for projection, and then you find the formula for reflection. It is very, once you are having formula for projection, easily you can find formula for reflection of a point with respect to that line. It is very simple. In next class, I will discuss about how to find matrix of reflection. So it would be twice of projection. So twice of this x2 divided by 1 in the direction of 0, 1 minus the same vector of which we are finding the projection, so minus x, that means minus x1, x2. So this is the formula of reflection. So using this formula, you can get that what is the reflection of this line, this point with respect to vertical line. It would be this. And if you are taking any point on the line itself, vertical line, the reflection of that point with respect to the same line, it would be the same point. So this two example you can observe here. Okay, so I should start with vector, but I think we are very close to 2 minutes remaining. Regarding attendance, go and mark your attendance there in Google's room. It might be already created there. If you face any problem, let me know. Okay, so vector is very interesting kind of things. It is very important in linear algebra. Regarding attendance, whether are you able to see the attendance link?
No, sir.
Not. Okay, then I might not have. Okay, I will create a attendance link.